to this little chapel here in Switzerland. It's Sunday the 15th of March, and we know what's happening with the virus. And here in Switzerland as well, all the churches have decided to close on this specific Sunday. Who knows what's going to happen in the future? Thanks for tuning in. Don't you just love going into little churches and learning about the kind of songbooks that they have? What's the version of the Bible? What's the inscription overhead here? It says, "Truly, truly, God's word will surely have its way like the Rhine River. You can swell it for a time, but never stop it." It reminds me of Isaiah 55:11. "So my word goes out from my mouth, it accomplishes what I send it to do, and it will not return to me void." That is the powerful word of God. You cannot stop it. It's going to accomplish all for the glory of God. I thought to myself praying this morning at 5:30 in the morning, "Kevin, take the church, take the good news of Jesus Christ to the people." So I came here this morning at 8 o'clock in the area of the Rhine Falls, and I shared the gospel with about 7 people. Great open conversations. One of the things that I like about this small drone that I fly, it attracts people, sometimes very positive, sometimes very negative. Oh, do I have stories. But this morning as I was flying it, a young guy came over. He's from Portugal. He's been here since he was 6 years old. And then he started, as we were talking about so many things, he started to pull out this grass, otherwise known as marijuana. He put it in his little cutter, chopped it up, put it in a $10 franc so he could slide it into his paper. He licked it, he put it on a filter, and he started to smoke it. And I said, "Well, which is better, to smoke a joint once a day or to have 3 beers a day? Which would you rather have, be addicted to marijuana or alcohol?" And he said, "Well, probably marijuana." We really did have a great conversation about life and death. What happens if one of us gets the coronavirus? What happens if we get hit by a train? What happens if, where would you go? And he really believes that he would go to heaven. And I said, "Why?" Well, he really didn't know the answer. I think that's very tricky these days. People think and believe and say that they're a Christian, but if you ask very simple questions, they just don't know the answer. In the beginning of our conversation, I says, "Alex is spelled A-L-E-X. He says, "Yes." And I started to write it down. He says, "Why are you doing that?" I says, "Well, I'm a police officer for Zurich. Don't you see my patch?" And he laughed. And I said, "No, I will be writing your name down because I will be praying for you that God would bless your life and draw you deeper and deeper into Christ Jesus." And he just stared like he couldn't believe what I just said. It's a blessing to tell people that you pray for them and you actually do it. He said, "Well, I hope that I can come back here." And I said, "I hope so too." So his name is Alex. Pray for him that God would lead him deep into the Word, into a good Bible church, and that he would grow in the grace and knowledge of Jesus Christ. Well, thanks everybody for tuning into this vlog. Please like and subscribe. Share it with your friends. Don't forget to pray for those people mentioned in this video. And until next time, auf Wiedersehen.